I am fine. I think you are also fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Today we are going to learn about changing person narration. To change person narration, you have to find out the... At first you should go through all the passages. You must read the passages, whole passages very carefully. Then you will find out the subject or person who is speaking and to who he is speaking. You must find out that thing. Then you will change the whole passage into assertive sentence as you did in your previous classes. That is, whenever you have changed the sentence narration, we must change the repeating verb, then conjunction, then person, tenses, and near verb. Everything. We will change everything in the passage narration also. Now I am going to give you an example. You follow me. The teacher said to the student, why did not you attend the class yesterday? Yes, sir. The student said, I was sick, sir. Don't miss the class. Okay. Suppose this is the part of a passage narration. Now we are going to change it. Before changing, you should find out the subject and object. That means the person who is speaking here and to whom he is speaking. We can see here, the teacher is the subject, or he is the subject who is talking. Then he is talking to a student. এখানে শিক্ষক ছাত্রের সাথে কথা বলতেছে, সাবজেক্ট হচ্ছে শিক্ষক অ্যান্ড স্টুডেন্ট হচ্ছে অবজেক্ট বা যার প্রতি এই কথাগুলো বলা হচ্ছে। Now we are going to change this passage narration into indirect speech. Okay, let's see how we can change it. You follow me? I am going to write down the answer. The teacher said to the student, within inverted comma you can see, why did not you attend the class yesterday? This is the part in within the inverted commas. So here we can see there is a question mark, interrogative mark. So we have to change this repeating verb, and this said to repeating verb will change into asked. Now we can write down the teacher asked the student. Then you can see, we know, in case of interrogative sentence, we have to omit this inverted comma and you have to add conjunction. If or whether. But we can see here, there is a WH question word. The sentence is started with WH question not. So we will not use any conjunction here. Just we'll write down the WH question not here. The teacher asked the student why. Then you come to person. You can see here you is a second person. So when, as you know, second person will follow the object. Second person follow the object. You know it in your previous class. Whenever you have done the changes the sentence narration, you second person will follow the object. Here so object is the student. So in case of the student, we will write down here he as the student's third person here. So we will write down he. The teacher asked the student why he. Then come to say, we will change the tense. You can see reporting verb is past tense. So we will change this part in the inverted commas into different tenses. Here it is, we can see past indefinite tense. So we will change it into past perfect tense. As you know, after subject, use have auxiliary verb. Then come to main verb, attend. You must write down B3 form, that means past participle form. Why he? Here you can see another not, so you must add here not. Not. Why he had not? Then B3 form of main verb. Attended. Why he had not attended the class? The class, you can see here near what yesterday, it will be changed. So, you know, in case of yesterday, we will write down here the day before or the previous day. Anyone? The day before. Now, up to this, we have write down the answer. We have just write down the answer up to this mark. Now come to this question. The student said, now you see the student is replying. What he is saying? The student is saying, I was 6 hours. Here you can see a new word, sir. So, in case of addressing sir or madam, we'll just add politely or respectfully the student replied. The student replied respectfully. Then the student said, I was sick, sir. Here you can see assertive part. So we will use here conjunction there. The student replied respectfully that. Then I was sick. Here you can see person, first person I. So it will follow the subject, the student. Here we write down he. I was sick. We will change the sentence. I was sick. Again, you can see. I was sick. This is the past tense. Past tense. So we'll change it into past perfect tense. Here we'll use add auxiliary verb. Then here we can see was is the main verb. So we'll change into B3 form. What is the B3 form of was? Been. That he had been sick. Okay. Just we have written down the answer up to this. Now, come to the next part. Don't miss the class. Here you can see there is no subject or object, but we can guess that who is telling me, who is speaking this part. Don't miss the class. This part is telling by the teacher. The teacher asking the student, advising the teacher, student, don't miss the class.
So here you can see, don't miss the class. This is the part of imperative sentence. This is imperative sentence. So we know, as you know, in case of imperative sentence, if it is advised, then we'll write down reporting verb advised. The teacher, subject is the teacher, because as you know, this part is saying by the teacher. The teacher advised the student. Advised the student. Advised the student. As you know, don't. If it is don't or never, we will write down first not to. Advise the student not to. Not to. Then miss the class. Rest of the part will be same. As you know, in case of imperative sentence, there will be a change of tense. In case of imperative sentence. So the rest part, from the main part, it will be same. As we have written down, not to miss the class. Okay, this is the answer of the of our passage narration. Please, I have written down on the board. So you must be clear about while you use changing passage narration, you must keep good idea on sentence narration. If you have good concentration of, you have good knowledge on your sentence narration, then it will be easy for you to change the narration to passage narration. Because passage narration and sentence narration are almost same, changing reporting verb, then person, conjunction, tense, everything is same. So we will write, add something. In case of passage narration, we will add something. Here, I used, in case of sir, I have write down respectfully. Or in case of yes, no, if there is no reply from the person who is speaking, if answer is come yes or no, then you will add replied in the affirmative or replied in the negative. Let's see another example. I think you can guess my class. You just follow me carefully, then you will be able to understand it. If you are not attentive, you will miss my instruction and in the class. The student, not the student, the teacher, let's see, the teacher say to the boy, said to the boy, how are you? How are you? I am fine. I am fine, sir. Said the boy. Did you attend class yesterday? Did you attend class yesterday? Did you attend class yesterday? Said the teacher. No, sir. No, sir. Suppose this is the part of another passage. So, how we will write down, change it. As you can see here, the teacher said to the boy, how are you? Here, subject is teacher and object is the boy. The person is speaking by the teacher and person is speaking the boy. And here is another interrogative sentence, you can say, how are you? So you have to write down the answer like this. The teacher, the teacher, again we'll use asked, because the part in the inverted commas is intermediate. So we'll write down here, asked, the putting verb. The teacher asked the boy, how? Here, another WS question mark, so we'll not add any conjunction here. How? Here is person you. You will follow the object, the boy. So we'll write down here he. In case of the boy, we'll write down he. How he? Then tense. As the putting verb is from past tense, so we change this part. Here you can see how are you. It's present tense, present indefinite. So we'll write down, change it into past indefinite. How he? Who was? Okay. This is the answer of this part. I am going to remove this. Okay. Now come to rest part. I am fine, sir, said the boy. Now this is the answer of the boy. The boy is answering that he was fine. So we'll write down here. The boy replied respectfully. The boy replied respectfully. Why it is respectfully? That you can see here, sir. If it is sir or madam, we will write down here respectfully or politely. The boy replied respectfully. Then again, I will use conjunction there, because this part is assertive sentence. So that will be the conjunction. Here you can see first person I will follow. First person will follow the subject, the boy. So we'll write down here he. Then we'll say this tense. I am fine. This is from present indefinite tense. So we'll write down here. We'll change it into past indefinite tense. He was fine. He was fine. Okay. Now come to next part. Did you attend class yesterday? Said the teacher. This is the part of the teacher. So, the teacher, again you can see, did you attend class yesterday? This is the interrogative sentence. So, we'll add here conjunction, reporting verb, asked. The teacher asked the boy, here you can see the interrogative sentence begin with auxiliary verb. So we'll add conjunction here, if. You have learned it in your changing sentence narration classes. So here will be if. Then come to person, you is the second person. It will follow the object, the boy. So we'll write down here he. Then change the tense. You see, you attend the, why did you attend the class yesterday? This is the part of a past indefinite tense. So we'll write down it into past perfect tense. So after subject, we'll add here had. If he had, then B3 form of the main verb, attended. Attended the class. The day before, or the previous day, anyone. The previous day. Okay. No, sir. This is the answer of the boy. No, sir. So, we'll write down here. The boy respectfully replied in the negative. Respectfully replied in the negative. Why it is in the negative? Because the boy said he was not in the class. No, sir. That's why we will add here in the negative. Reply with the negative. This will be the answer of the second passage. So I think you have come to learn something new here. If it is answer no, then we'll write in the negative. If it is answer yes, we'll add in the affirmative. So I think you have gained some knowledge from my class today. We'll discuss rest part of the passage narration tomorrow. So be careful. Take care of your health. That's all for today. Thank you very much.